So, is this perfectly, sorry, is this perfectly feasible?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay. Okay, so today we will mostly see how this course is going to be delivered. What will be the content? How will be the evaluation? And how will you get the certificate? And the tools that we are going to use in this course. So as the name suggests, artificial intelligence. So basically bringing in some kind of intelligence to the robotics or machines is what comes under this term artificial intelligence. You might have came across these words like artificial intelligence, machine learning, data science, etc. many number of times in this couple of months or maybe last 2 3 years. These things.
सर, कुड यू प्लीज इंक्रीज योर वॉइस?
ओके, जस्ट अ मोमेंट. Is it okay now? Or still you have some difficulty?
Yeah, it's better now.
Okay. So you can again inform me if you find it difficult to hear. So this term artificial intelligence is coming now and then everywhere. Okay. So why this is gaining so much popularity? Is it a term that is used only in last 5 years or 10 years? No. So we have, or some of you might have already worked on this, maybe in your first year or second year, or maybe in your 12th. You might have used some different name. So the work in this domain started gaining popularity from last 30 to 40 years, and with the introduction of more flexible tools and generation of data in this today's 3G and 4G network community, and we are getting more and more data. More people are getting interested towards analysis of that data and carrying out some work or some form of application, developing some application using that data. So that is why everywhere you can see that there are new branches coming in this data science field. Or if you go through the Facebook or maybe on any digital platform, you will see that not only the leading universities but also national level institutes are coming up with their own graduate diploma courses in this field. So basically, whenever there is data, designing of some application and analysis of that data is gaining popularity. So if you see that our today's life is totally digital life, Google knows what what I am doing, right? You might have came across some joke on social media that Google is denying some customer to purchase a cake. Why? Because Google knows that the person is diabetic and he is not taking proper medicines. So how Google knows? Because Google has access to all our activities or data associated with us in one or other form. If I have to walk from college to my home, Google tells me which is the correct path, in what shorter duration of time I can reach there, what are the alternatives, what is the real time traffic on that route. So that is to the analysis of acquired data. If I go to Amazon and purchase something, or if I explore some product, Amazon next time will show a similar kind of pattern whenever I will log into the Amazon. Or else if I go to some other web pages which have access to your Amazon data, it will also show you the same pages or similar kind of products. So this is generally done using recommender system. So how this recommender system works? Or else, nowadays if we go to most of the websites, the first step to contact the customer care is through some chatbot. So how that chatbot is designed? Or another example, if we can say, if I have some Amazon device, I can give the order to Alexa. Okay, we have Siri, we have Cortana. So how all these voice assisted devices work? So what is voice assisted command? All such kind of applications that come under either machine learning or artificial intelligence or data science or big data, all these terms are associated with each other. So artificial intelligence is something very broad. So it involves machine learning, then robotics, natural language processing, and few other things. Whereas machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence in which we train certain algorithm to do a desired task. So, in due course of time, we will be able to differentiate between artificial intelligence and machine learning. So, machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. So this objective of this particular program is to make you industry 4.0 ready. So you might have came across this term industry 4.0, in which such courses like artificial intelligence, machine learning, 3D printing, IoT, they are gaining much popularity, and there is a much scope of getting job in this field. So that's why government is promoting training in these various disciplines. So task or aim or objective of this particular workshop or training is to make you industry ready in the field of artificial intelligence. But learning is a continuous process. So within a span of 40 to 80 hours, that we may spend on this particular course, you may not be able to gain that much proficiency which is required to get a job in Amazon or Facebook, but definitely you can get some insight based on which you can work and you can take some job in some MNC. Okay, and if you can excel, definitely you can go to Amazon or Intel or Facebook, something like that. So here we have four faculty members who will be actively involved in teaching as well as in conduction of labs. Professor Bhatt from Electronics Department is also available in the meeting. I request him to switch on his camera or maybe share a few words. Bhatt sir.
Thank you very much for providing me such an opportunity.
You are not like,
thank you, sir. Thank you, Suhas, sir, for giving me such an opportunity to interact with the students. Actually, like, it is the energy of the teacher that always like come from the students. The how much the enthusiasm the student will be, the more eager the teacher will be. So it is like give and take session. Like, so if the student will not like show his or her energy in the session, then it's not easy for a faculty to deliver that kind of lecture. Of like that much of energetic lecture that will be, or the informative lecture will be. So I welcome all the participants first, because they are nothing but the like our source of energy to conduct all these sessions. Because until and unless we cannot deliver our knowledge into our down channel, so and it will be get utilized by the students, the a motto of like taking the lecture is not going to be completed, right? So first I welcome all the students, and especially the Suhas sir, who is taking that much of effort to make this whole event a great success, because it is the legacy of College of Engineering Pune that we actually believes in delivering the knowledge to the best of ourselves by taking that much of pain to our students, because it's like the timing of the college is from 10 to 5, so still we are here from like 6 to 7:30 or 7 or 8 to make our knowledge whatever we have to deliver among our students. So welcome all the students, and Suhas sir, and we have two more faculty members, maybe they were not being present at this particular session. So as such, it is like one of like when we talk about the baseline of this particular course, that is artificial intelligence. So it is like one of the thrust area of today's research domains. Whenever we go to any university or any other institute, the research in artificial intelligence exists in each and every branch of engineering, whether it is like electrical or mechanical or electronics or computer science or whatsoever it is, or maybe it is in civil also. The artificial intelligence is like going to present everywhere, because our motive to make our machines to be think like how a person can think, right? So actually what we are giving the machines the liberty to think like human. But maybe it is not like 100% possible. So every time when we discuss about machine learning algorithms, we will talk a very good term that is called accuracy assessment, because none of the thing at perfect 100% as like human being. Because we can take it as a simple example. If suppose I have seen a particular person, a simple cat, so he or she can detect out of 10,000 of cats, whether they are cat or not. But if I suppose I will show a machine, or I will train a machine for like, for example, 10,000 sets of data of the cat images, then maybe there's a time when a machine cannot detect the particular image of a cat, or the machine gives us the wrong information. So every time we will discuss the accuracy assessment part with each and every algorithm. बट वी आर मोर और लेस टूवर्ड्स लाइक एक्यूरेट लाइक अ ह्यूमन ब्रेन. वी आर गोइंग टू ट्रेन द मशीन लाइक अ ह्यूमन ब्रेन एंड दैट कम्स द पार्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. एंड एज सच सुहास सर हैज गिव्स यू सो मैनी एग्जाम्पल्स. सो एक्चुअली वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू ब्रिंग यू, वी आर ब्रिंगिंग यू इन अ सेट ऑफ एनवायरमेंट. वी आर गोइंग टू मेक एन एनवायरमेंट टू ऑल ऑफ यू सो दैट यू कैन थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स एंड यू कैन थिंक हाउ एक्चुअली वी कैन क्रिएट दैट काइंड ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग एल्गोरिदम विच विल गिव यू अ मोर अप्रोक्सीमेट टूवर्ड्स लाइक अ ह्यूमन ब्रेन. दैट्स वाई द टर्म दैट कम्स ओवर हियर दैट इज वी आर टेकिंग द टर्म दैट इज न्यूरल नेटवर्क बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली इट इज द न्यूरोन्स दैट ट्रांसफर द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन अ ह्यूमन माइंड. और वेन एवर लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई गोइंग टू टच अ वेरी लाइक वॉर्म थिंग देन इट सिंपली मेक्स अस द सेंस लाइक द थिंग इज वॉर्म और पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज वॉर्म. सो हाउ इट द इन्फॉर्मेशन इज गोइंग टू बी ट्रांसफर टू योर ह्यूमन माइंड इट इज एक्चुअली थ्रू दिस न्यूरल न्यूरॉन्स इन अवर बॉडी. सो द सेम द टर्म्स कम्स फ्रॉम देयर दैट इज न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो इफ यू आर इफ एक्चुअली इट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग दैट इट इज वेरी मच रिलेटेड विद द फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी थिंग. इफ यू गेट इन टू द टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग इफ यू कैन इफ यू आर गोइंग टू एक्सेस द टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग देन लाइक 50% ऑफ योर वर्क हैज बीन डन. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज अ वर्ड कम्स दैट इज एक्सपेक्टेशन मैक्सिमाइजेशन एल्गोरिदम EM एल्गोरिदम. सो इट इज द वर्ड दैट हैज बीन रिटन ओवर देयर एक्सपेक्टेशन मैक्सिमाइजेशन. सो इफ यू गोन थ्रू द टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग इफ यू आर एबल टू ग्रास द टर्मिनोलॉजी And you can easily get the idea of that particular algorithm. For example, if we discuss about Gaussian mixer model, so it is like Gaussian wave. So everybody knows what actually Gaussian is. So if you are going to relate everything with the terminology of engineering, then you can easily get the idea behind what actually that algorithm is going to do, right? So I would suggest here to present in the session. For whole of the time, don't miss it because ultimately we are why we are doing all these things, why we are taking that much of pain. This is nothing but for you students only because all of you are like the shining stars of COEP. So if you are going to learn, if you get the knowledge out of it, then it will be the like it was like best thing for us. If you are going to deliver these things in some practical scenarios also. So hope I have. Deliver my basic thoughts behind that all this course is all about. And in next session or in the next time or the in next my colleague that is Suhas sir will deliver you more about what actually the course outline is, right? So thank you and all the best and happy learning, right? Thank you. So over to you, Suhas sir.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, so thank you very much, sir, for giving such insight to the, our objective.
Yeah.
Again, I will share the syllabus with them and then maybe I will ask you to show them how to join on Colab and Kaggle.
Okay.
So you can continue with Colab and Kaggle, and after that, I will give them the description of course. And then maybe I will tell them about Jupiter and other stuff quite
Right. Right. So students, first we go on through the how we can like install the various actually the basic bone behind this particular whole of the artificial intelligence courses is to make you like very much familiar with the practical use of the machine learning and the artificial intelligence algorithms, right? So the thing is there, we can have various ways, like for example, as the name is stated, that is called machine learning. So it is very much related with the mathematics actually. So everything that can be defined with the help of a mathematical equation, that particular model can be built up into this machine learning, or which that can be built up with the help of machine learning. So how we can deal with all these like scenarios? For that we there is two three platforms that are available to execute our machine learning operations, right? So am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So there is one of the option that is available over here, that is
I will first let my like share my screen first. So, could you able to see my screen?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sir?
Just short, hold on.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah, so just give me a minute. So, students, some of you might be knowing me. I'm Suhas Thakre, working as assistant professor in electrical engineering domain. My area of expertise is computer vision, machine learning, kinesthetic haptic perception, and embedded systems. So I usually deal with electronics related subjects of electrical engineering department. Whereas Professor Bhatt is associate professor, so he's a doctor. He has earned his PhD from IIT Kharagpur. IIT Roorkee in image processing, and his area of expertise is again artificial intelligence, machine learning, image processing, and in that specifically satellite image processing. He is also author of this is writing a book on satellite image processing. So he has a very good expertise in this field, and he has a rich experience of working in this particular field. Okay, so this is our brief introduction. Apart from that, we have two more faculty members involved, but they are not available. They did not join the they could not join the meeting today. So whenever you start their session in due course of time, you will introduce them with you. Okay, so over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. So right. So are you able to view my screen, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. Okay. Great. So there are two, three options that I have already discussed to you, which are being available with all these. Just hold on. So we start with that. So the first thing first, that how we can like make our codes and make them able to run, right? So the very easiest way to use this machine learning codes to be run, that is using Google Colab. For that, what you have to do is simply go on to the web browser and simply write on the Google, that is Google Colab. That can be viewed, you can view over here. It is Google Colab. You can simply click that particular Google Colab tab. If you have that laptop or if you are attending the session on a computer, you can simply work with me to running all these things. So here we can connect with the Google Colab. So it is the Google Colab. You can find out the collaboratory, or Colab for short, allows you to write and execute Python in your browser with zero configured required, free access to GPUs and easy sharing. Means that actually what had happened when we run the machine learning codes, then maybe they required the GPUs and the CPUs to run that particular code, because the codes are very much lengthy Actually, what had happened when we run the machine learning course, then there may be a chance that you can get a, like you have a number of models that you have to run simultaneously. Well, means thousands or millions of models that you have to run at a single time. So it is not easy for our own system or our simple laptop to run such kind of codes simultaneously in a very short span of time. So that we need such kind of system where we can have the support from APUs so that we can run that particular code. So for that we have this platform that is being available by the Google, and it is very free of cost. You can easily you can easily use that particular Google Colab platform using Google. And but for that, the single thing that you require, that is you have a email ID, or that is called Gmail ID, and you have a drive. So I simply sign in with my Google account. I will sign in with my Google account, and it simply move me to the Google Colab option. So I have a Google Colab research.doc. So it is being whatever the notebook that you have created or whatever the code that you have been created is simply going to be stored in your Google Colab repository. So there is no need to store any kind of install any kind of libraries, because every time, suppose that I'm working with Python or I'm working with any kind of platform available like Anaconda that will be discussed by Suhas sir later on. So for that you have to install various kind of library. If suppose that I have to use the numerical data, then you have to install the library called NumPy. Or if I have used to data in various kind of domains, then you have to install Pandas. Or there is various kind of libraries. For example, if I have to work with image processing system, then I have to install a TensorFlow library. So I have to install various kind of libraries to make my Python code to be run. But here in the case of a Google Colab, I don't need to install any kind of library. It's simply taken the libraries from Google and run the code for you. So I can store my Python notebook or any kind of notebook into this Google Colab repository, and I can run directly from here, right? So if or I can create a new notebook, that for example, if I will create a new notebook and I will simply make a new notebook and will write the name of the notebook, say for example, is loading. So here it is. So I can use this collaboratory or the Google Colab window to write my code, as well as it is going to directly save in my Google Drive. Like for example, if I give that particular name, like for example, my first Python code. So it's simply going to save with this name in my Google Drive. When I'm going to access my Google Drive from here, then I can simply go and find out that particular. Actually, it is why IPYNB, that is Interact with Python Notebook. IPYNB stands for. So it is the name of the file that is going to be stored in my Google Drive and the extension that it has, Interactive Python Notebook that I have. So I can even open or if I locate the drive or wherever I have, or we will discuss these particular terms also again, and save a copy in my GitHub account. So I can open my GitHub account, I can correlate this my notebook with GitHub. So when as soon as I will going to update my Google Colab Python notebook, here only it is going to update my GitHub repository all at a time, right? At the same time, right? So they are like in synchronization. So then again we have various options available here, that like edit, view, insert. So we can insert various kind of code cell or the text cell. Code cell means we can add a code over here, and text we can add a text over here. Like for example, if I will add a tag, like for example, my first code for Python. So it simply add my text over here in the repository. However, this is my code window. Wherever you can get this particular cell sign over here, we can run that particular cell. Like for example, if I like give an input that will be discussed in later classes. Now at this time I will show you a simple code. Like for example, x is equal to input, and then I give a inverted commas, and I will give what is your name, right? I will give and make it a run. I will make it a run and it was simply going to ask me so it's going to ask me what is your name. Suppose that I will make one more cell over here. I will make, say, I will say print, and then I will say hello. And then the comma and give the value x. Now if I will run that again, I will stop it and I will run it again. So I will give my name, it asks me for the input. Suppose that I will write my input, that is say for example, is my name is Abhishek Bhatt, and then put enter. Then it simply print me hello Abhishek Bhatt. So I can run the code from here, I can store my code over here, and I can shift my cells ups and downs. So say for example, I have like this is my code cell. I want to insert a code cell over here, or I can insert my text cell over here, or whatever I want to add a form of field or whatsoever it is. So I can do any like interactive kind of coding with this Google Colab. So even we can have here, that is various sections available here. So this is my various sections that I have. I can add various section into it. However, there is a repository inside. We can go to the various example, or we can have various, for like for example, we have forms examples, and we can interact in this way. We can write whole of the code and run it with the help of the Google CPUs and GPUs. So like for example, we can learn the Python over here, that for example, what is the string field, what is raw field, date field, number field, and so many things are here. So even I can run the codes, we can check, for example, text the value or whatsoever. It's like very interactive thing, interactive sort of things. You can learn so many things from here, even how you can code all the like kinds of programs. Even I can check for any kind of tools available here. Then we have command palette, so we can run particular add or code cell and whatsoever we have. So it is kind of like I can create my Python notebook from here. So it is one of the option where we can use the Google Colab to run this particular code and create the code. And we can, like, in this particular code, I can, well, like, normal world file that we can create. We can find and replace. We can go to the directory and whatsoever. So this is all about like Google Colab, that we can run the codes from here. And if we make a sign out, we can just make it sign out over here. So all the changes that you have done, that will be saved to Google repository itself, right? So it is getting started. Like for example, it is giving a simple code. Now to execute the code in the above cell, select it. And now there are two, three options where we can run a particular code. Either we can write control plus enter, or we can write shift plus enter. What had happened actually, if I put a shift and enter, if I press shift and enter, then it will make, again, start pressing to sign in, okay? But again, if I make a shift and enter, then the cursor remains in the cell itself. But if suppose I will run control plus enter, then it comes to the next cell, it creates another cell, and then we can code it in another cell. So we have the various kind of like help files available over there. For example, data science, we have the NumPy and the matplotlib, so there are, you can visualize it. So we have the various kind of these commands that we will discuss later. We have to import all the libraries first, that we will, these are the basics that we will discuss later. Now the machine learning, as I have told you earlier, with Colab you can import an image data set, train an image classifier on it, and evaluate the model all in just a few lines of codes. Colab notebooks execute codes on Google Cloud servers, meaning you can leverage the power of Google hardware, including GPUs and TPUs. TPUs stand for Tensor Processor Unit. Actually, what had happened, all the image processor related tasks has been done in Tensor Processing Units, because we have a separate library for image processing that's called TensorFlow library. So regardless of the power of your machine, all you need is a browser only. So left all the things, leave out all the things, what you have to install on your laptop or not, or if whatever the like capacity of your system, whether it is up to mark, whether it is a 6 GB RAM or 4 GB RAM or 8 GB RAM, whatsoever it is. You can simply need a browser and the Google account. You can run all the things on using Google Colab. So there are some more resources working with notebook in Colab. So guide to Markdown, as soon as later on when we are going to very much friendly with the Google Colab, we will get to know all the things, how we can load the notebooks in Google Colab, or how we can load the our notebook in the GIT Hub. So we have the various crash courses also available. You can go through all these things if you want to learn more and more, because we have the introduction to pandas, TensorFlow concept, first step with TensorFlow, introduction to neural nets, introduction to sparse data and embedding. Like for example, if I go with introduction to pandas, pandas actually like used to extract the data, whatever the kind of data, like for example, it is being available into the data and into the CSV files or Excel files or whatever it is basically called data frame. So import CSV data into the pandas and re-index the data frame to shuffle data, how we can like manipulate with the data. Like for example, if suppose I have a household data of US, so for example, the data may contain 100 numbers of attributes. Like for example, if I take a simple example of a class of any student, so a class of the student may have 60 students and each of the students have various data inputs. Like for example, each student have its roll number, its CGPA, its father's name, and blood group, or and the previous marks and everything it has. So based upon the kind of analysis that you want to execute, like suppose that you want to segregate how many male and female are into the classes, then we need to have only one column that is gender. So we need to have that particular column only irrespective of the data is none of our use, because we have to find out nothing but the number of male and female in a class. So for that particular thing, we need to have which particular frame or which particular column is need to be used that will be manipulated using this pandas library. So you need not to install that pandas library into your laptop, however it can work directly with the Google Colab. And along with that, each and every, like for example, when I'm moving a cursor with each and every, like for example, this particular cell, each and every, this thing is called cell. So when I move to the cursor, then we have an option, either we have to add a code cell or we have to add a text cell. So we can do all these things with this particular Google repository or Google Colab. Then accessing data, and so various things are available over here, that introduction to pandas and all these. So right, we can add a new section using of it. So this is all about the Google Colab. So we have some basic idea about Google Colab, how it's going to run. Then we have some examples over here also. So we have a machine learning examples. You can, these are the pre-built examples, pre-built data. How you can simply access these all examples and you can learn them. Like for example, text classification, retraining an image classifier, then style transfer and all these things are there. So this is one thing, that is Google Colab, right? And the another thing is we can make a GIT Hub account and we can run the GIT Hub using this GIT Hub desktop. But for that, you have to write in Google, just simply write it GIT Hub desktop. So we can write this GIT Hub desktop. So it is actually again an interactive kind of desktop. So we have, just click it over here. It is going to ask you the GIT Hub desktop download for Windows or Mac OS. So we can download it or the, for whatever the kind of OS that we have. Suppose that I have downloaded for Windows, so we can download from here only. So you can just simply click download for Windows 64. It is going to install. I have already pre-installer for it. So I have just recently installed it. So if I will go through the desktop, this is my GIT desktop that I have over here. So for that, I have to sign into my GIT Hub account. So for that, you have to create a GIT Hub account. You can easily create a GIT, maybe most of you have that GIT Hub account. So we have a GIT Hub account. So we can have a GIT Hub login. We can go through here. So it is already logged in for me. It's already logged in. I have the CID have account. So you can also from here you can create a repository. So you can create a repository over here, and you can easily, as well as you can start a project. So suppose that I have to start a project, you can directly code it over here. You can use it as an owner repository name. You just given the name it over here. Like for example, I'm giving it my file one. We have simply created a my file one description. You can write it over here. Like for example, I will write it image analysis, and you simply write it image analysis, and then make it like it is public or private, whatever you like to create. Then this will create, then we have it. So it will create a repository to you. Got it. Now we can import the code if you have written somewhere else, or you can write your code over here using the various repositories, using the various, again, interactive environment that you have over here. So creating a new file or uploading an existing file or whatsoever it is. So we can create your existing new file. Like for example, I have created this. For example, I will use this. So you can watch this probability. Sorry, so that I have to open it. So here I have my Python notebook over here in the Google Colab. So it is the basically data that I have added earlier into the file that I have created earlier. So basically the various concepts related to probability and linear algebra that I have already taught to some PG students. So we can have this equation over here. Hello. So again, I have back. So it is like something that I have already written over here. So maybe I have a call from here. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, ma'am, bus eight. Just 1 minute, ma'am. हाँ सुहास सर, मैं कह रहा हूँ प्रोजेक्ट पे आपको टेक ओवर करना पड़ेगा एक्चुअली वो। हाँ, तो मैं कह रहा हूँ कि आपको टेक ओवर करना पड़ेगा एक्चुअली। एक वो पीजी का एक वो आ गया स्टूडेंट, उसका ना प्रेजेंटेशन है ना, मैं वो जरा निपटा लेता हूँ। जी, है ना, ठीक है।
हेलो, मैं ऑडिबल। तो
यस सर,
यस सर।
सर सम इमीडिएट वर्क, सो वी हैव टू लीव इन बिटवीन, बट ही विल बी जॉइन। सो एज ही वाज डिस्कसिंग दैट गूगल कोलैब इज वन ऑफ द थिंग दैट यू जस्ट अ मोमेंट, लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन। Is it visible?
यस सर,
यस सर।
Yeah. So what he was suggesting you to use Google Colab. So it's a platform from Google that stands for Co-Laboratory, in which we can perform our experiments. So basically, for image processing or video processing kind of thing, there we have, basically for image processing, we have some library. Like those who are familiar with C, they know that we need to use multiple libraries depending upon our application in a given program, right? So what those libraries contains? They contains some already some predefined functionality. Okay, so here also you have to use multiple libraries. For image processing, mostly you can use TensorFlow. So TensorFlow is designed by Google. There are other libraries also, which some people may not like to use TensorFlow because of certain reasons. They may use PyTorch. So nowadays this PyTorch and TensorFlow are most widely used. So there are others also like Caffe and some other things, but we will focus mostly on two. One is TensorFlow, and so this is from Google Colab. So in this Colab, all these libraries are already installed, and as sir suggested, your program will be stored either on GitHub. So you can have account on GitHub. So many data sets are available, many codes are available on this GitHub. So I can see that in that list of registrations of 240 students, there are students from metallurgy also as well as computer also. So we have, and planning also. So we have students from all the disciplines. So this AI or ML is just a tool to solve the problems in your own discipline. So on this GitHub, you can find out the data set associated with the problem in your domain or specialization. Okay, and you can work upon that. So Google Colab has direct access with GitHub. TensorFlow is one of the library that we are going to use, or there is another library from Facebook AI Research Group that is called as PyTorch, which is also very famous. Okay, so sir may take, Abhishek sir may take some of the problems based on this TensorFlow, and maybe some other faculty will take based on PyTorch. So this, for that you can have flavor of both the libraries. Okay, but all of you should have account on. So I hope everyone must have Google account, Gmail account, right? With Gmail account, you can access Google Colab. Okay, so I'm deleting this. Then should have account on GitHub. Then, just like Google Colab, we have another online platform that is known as Kaggle. Okay, so a lot of competitions are going on every day. If any of my good students is available, I don't know whether they have taken the workshop or not. I usually host some competition over here. Okay. And there are many competitions, so you can even win the prizes. Many data sets are available. Okay. Maybe some weather prediction. Okay, so some weather data is there. Now if I have to forecast what will be the percentage of precipitation tomorrow, okay, at a given location, if this data belongs to that location, I may be able to find out how much it is going to rain. Okay, so likewise, huge data set is available, but first of all, you need to register here. So, all of you can register. You can even register with your Google account or with college account. Now, I might be having my Gmail account connected over here. Okay, so this is my Gmail account. Okay, this is how your account looks. Then you can have here various competitions in which you can take part. Or else, if I create some courses here, maybe I can also create some courses here, just like these courses are there. For your class, you will be having login ID and password to enter into that, and then you have to write down the code over there and submit it. Okay. So likewise, we can have courses, we can have competitions. So we can write down here our code. Here I can click on new notebook. Here also we need not install any library. All the libraries, like you can see that import NumPy as NP. So this library is required for linear algebra. Import pandas as PD. So for the tables and time series data. For some numerical data, we need pandas library. So all these libraries are already there. Okay, and maybe here I can click on this code and I can start writing down my code from this point on. So today I am not going to write down anything, but this is where we have to again create our account. Okay. So this particular software is known as Kaggle. So it's a web browser. Okay. Here also we can use the Jupyter Notebook. So I will come what is Jupyter Notebook and what is Python. I will come towards that point. Okay. So just I am giving you what are our accounts or softwares you should have. Okay, so we can use Google Colab and Kaggle only. Then we will, so basically this is regarding accounts. Then we may also use some software that is known as Wicca. Some of you might be familiar. Maybe one or two sessions we will take on this Wicca. Okay. Then the programming language that we are going to use is Python. But the backend of Python may be C only. But this Python is also pretty old language. This is not a new language. So the new language which are based on Python are like Google Rust, Google Go, okay? So you might not have heard these names because they are not available in the market, but they are in development stage. So Rust or Go you can search for. So Python is pretty old, okay? So but so we can do all these courses which we are going to learn, not only in Python but also in C, C++, or else in Java you can write down, in MATLAB you can write down. But the thing is, well, MATLAB generally we won't prefer because we need to pay for that, right? So mostly the researchers who are working in this domain, they use Python. So Python is again user friendly, just like C, but its syntax is pretty simple as compared to C, and it executes this data processing task with much higher speed as compared to that of C. So this is optimized for data processing, whereas C is not optimized. That's why we prefer Python over C. But at the back end of Python, it is so C and C++, we call them collectively as C only. So you can do it either in C or C++. Okay. But what language will prefer is Python only. So based on this Python only, all these things are available. Then software that we said, one is Weka. So Weka is generally used for some image processing applications. Everything is inbuilt there, but again, many people won't use that. Okay, so this is just for introduction. Then what people use? Well, some of you might be having Linux or operating environment, some might be having Mac, some might be having Windows. Okay, so usually people use Conda in Linux. So either it is Miniconda or Anaconda, that doesn't matter. So what is Anaconda that we can use even with from Linux? Usually we use Conda. We can also install Anaconda, but let us talk about Miniconda. What is Anaconda? It is some software which has collection of certain tools which can be used to write down the code. Generally, these tools are called as notebooks in case of Jupyter, etc. Just like you have .m location, sorry, .m extension in MATLAB or .c or .cpp. Here you have some extension of file, ipnyb or maybe ip. Okay, so either you can run these Python files, Python code to your terminal if you are using Linux. Or in Linux also you can install GUI. Okay, so there is, at this moment we will not go for optimized solution. We will install full Anaconda, and in that we will use two different softwares. First is Jupyter. We can use any of these also, but there is some advantage and disadvantage associated with each of them. Second is Spider. So what Jupyter does, here in Jupyter you can execute line by line, or in each cell I have installed Anaconda just now. So here you can execute cell by cell or block by block or entire code. Whereas here you can execute entire code. Okay. So Jupyter is good for teaching. Spider is good for coding. So if you are doing some task, I think you need not teach to the student at that time. Spider is teaching. Okay. Whereas, or if you can also use Jupyter that time, but this Jupyter, it is good, very good tool for explaining your code. And if you need not explain to anyone, Spider can be utilized. Okay. Then in that Python, the software that we are going to use, there are two variants. One is maybe 2.7, and other is 3.3 or 3. Something. Maybe 2.6, 2.8. Okay, 2.star and 2.star. If you go through GitHub or other programming, like the paperswiftcode.com, where the data sets and codes are available, you can see that there are many codes or old work which are based on Python 2.7 or 2.8. Okay. Wherever, whatever new comes, new works are coming, all the utilizes Python 3.something. So basically, we will go with Python 3.something because in the future, Python 3.something will be there. Right now, there is a support for 2.something as well as 3.something, but in future, this may be obsolete. Then newer versions may also come that we don't know at this moment. Okay, so what will be working is on Python 3.something. Then online we can use Google Colab and Kaggle. GitHub is for data, and offline we can use Jupyter and Spider. Okay, so these are all the software that we need to utilize. Is it correct? Are you getting it? Do you have any question till this point? So you can see that this
yes,
is
sir.
Okay. And upon an editor, so from command prompt also you can execute. You will not see other options. What you will do is either you can use this Jupyter notebook, which is here, or you can use the Spider. Okay. So well, so this Jupyter or Spider or rather Python that we are using is good for programming. If given a task, I have to just code something. This Python is good. There is another language which is called as R. So here you can see this R Studio. We may have one or two examples with R. So what this R does, so this is also a good software or coding, you cannot say coding language, coding language, just like you are seeing for this machine learning task, but this has got very good statistical setup. So whenever you have to perform some task, which has got significant statistical meaning, then R Studio is good. But if you have some fancy application, then Python is good. So you can even use R, but R is good for what? R is good for statistics. Okay? Then you have to perform you have done some coding and you have to perform ANOVA. This is just for example, a very simple example. Okay. Or you have to obtain the X score. So these tools which are available in both of these, but for complex operations, R is more stable as compared to Python. Okay. Yeah. So coming back towards our this system, what we are going to learn. So these are our learning outcomes. As you have COs and outcomes to each of the course. Similarly, here too we have. So you should learn and understand classical and modern AI. So what is classical AI? So in case of classical AI, we have certain algorithms which supervise, unsupervised, reinforcement learning. So there will be regression and classification and supervised and unsupervised. Some terms are there. Right now we don't know what are those terms, but in the course of time, we will get familiar with that. And modern AI, starting with this neural network, we have deep learning networks. So how this AlexNet works, or audio networks, image networks, what are those architectures, okay, what is investment to use, all these things we will study under modern AI. Okay, then whatever problem may come, we have to, it has a learning problem. Learning problem is a machine learning problem. Like, suppose if I am designing a calculator in C, I have four basic operations to do: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so I can put four if else condition, and then I will ask the user what you exactly want to do. Depending on that, user will give the input. I may enter the number, or user may enter the number, and he will get the solution. Okay, based on the operation. Now, apart from this code, differentiation terms or differentiation terms, and you have not written the code for that. So how? Okay, screen is blurred. It means there is some problem at your end. I don't think that the screen. My voice is it not still clear? Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, but sir, your voice is
very low.
Yes,
sir.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Is it better than the previous one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Okay, so we have to present any problem as a machine learning problem, that how integration or differentiation can be performed from addition and subtraction. Okay. So machine will itself learn. We will not code. Given the code for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay. Then we have to see the role of data in modern AI. All these algorithms, they rely only on data. Whatever data you will give, based on that only, we have some reference. We can have so from the data, applying some algorithm, we can have some results, and from that result, we have some solution to the problem. Okay, so some inference. So whatever inference that we will draw with the support of some statistics, it is totally based on the data. Okay, so if data is wrong, or inference is definitely going to wrong. Hence, data pre-processing has much importance in this field. Okay, first data is processed, then we have to train and evaluate our algorithms. Okay, so that is the next outcome, and then we need to use these modern frameworks, maybe this TensorFlow, PyTorch, etc. Okay, and using that we have to design a chatbot or something. So definitely in this workshop we will design some simple chatbot. Okay, so there are four different modules. The first module is fundamentals of modern AI. So in the next week we'll complete this entire module. So history of AI, some basic programming on linear algebra and probability, then classical AI, so some searching algorithms that which you already have studied. Okay, so those who are with computer background or electronics background, they might have studied search algorithms, and then the basics of machine learning, so in which we have like classification, regression, so kind of supervised and unsupervised learning that we are going to see. And the second module will be deep learning, which will be taken by a professor from ENTC department. So we'll start with basic neural network. So what is input layer, output layer, hidden layer, what is weight, what is bias, what are fully convolutional neural network, so FCN, CNN, RNN, all these terms we'll see in the second unit. Okay, then application of that to the text, images, and speech, and some kind of some portion of AI that is perception, we will cover in third unit, which will be taken by some professor in computer department. And last one is planning. So this is reinforcement learning, that is planning under uncertainty, Markov decision process, multi-agent systems, recommender system, like how Amazon recommends you. So such kind of systems we will see in planning. Okay, so this will be taken by Abhishek sir, who had given you introduction on Google Colab. Okay, based on this, along with me, Abhishek sir and a faculty from computer department is going to conduct the practicals. So mostly our practical sessions will be of 3 hours. So that we will decide mutually. Okay, so practicals will be based on these things only, that whatever we will cover in theory sessions. Okay, now apart from that, there will also be a mini project. So you have to form group of two or three or at the max 4 students among yourself, and you can take any problem in your domain which can be solved using ML or AI, and then you have to give a short presentation maybe of 10 minutes at the end. Okay, Then on each of these modules, there will be test. So this will take 1 week, this will take another week. These 2 weeks will take 4 weeks together. So at the end of each module, you have to give one test, maybe based on MCQ. Then whatever that this thing you have given, just let me go to Moodle. So I have to submit your data to the NPIU, that is a National Agency for TechVIP, who are sponsoring this event. Then they will send your data to NASSCOM. NASSCOM will send you some link for the registration for their examination. Okay, so here I have created an URL for a list of enrolled students. Now, some of you have given proper information, or most of you have given proper information, but some of you, they have not mentioned their full name, or their email ID is not proper, or they have not given their WhatsApp number. Okay, so I request that all of you should check this data. Okay, like this Gavande, he has not given here anything. So how can I trace him? Okay, some of you have given email IDs, Gmail IDs. So we want institute email ID. Few email IDs, institute email IDs are not proper. Similarly, I have added one more column, that is for gender. So this information is required by TechVIP cell. Okay, so you have to fill this. So this URL available. On the web page or Moodle page of our course. Okay, then that is one thing. So from that you can come to know who are all your friends. Okay, and then you can form group among yourself, and you can start searching some problem which can be addressed in due course of time. Okay, so on Monday is the last date for me to submit your information on that NPIU portal. So before inauguration, I should have your registration clear from their side. So it's my humble request that today only you should fill the data, and those who are not attending this today's class, you should inform them also. So I can see around 100 participants right now. 93 are there, but in the list there are around 243. Okay, some might have left, so maybe around 236 or 239. So please tell your friends who have registered to give me all the details, including gender, so that I can send that list to the TechVIP or NPIU, Delhi office of TechVIP. I can get the permission. Okay, then they will send that to, they will say send it to NASSCOM. NASSCOM is the agency which is recruited by NPIU to conduct your exams. So there will be two exams from their side based on this syllabus. First you can treat as a mid-sem, second you can treat as end-sem. So in case of mid-sem syllabus, whatever we can cover, that will be the syllabus for mid-sem, and all four modules will be there for the end-sem. Okay, so you have to score at least 75% in their exam in order to get the certificate. Once you will get the certificate, it means that you are qualified and have good knowledge in. So it is a government certification that you have good knowledge in AI. So that will add some weightage to your resume. Okay. And you can have increased opportunity for your placement. Apart from that, so apart from V4, there is a keynote speech by our deputy director on it. Okay. Then there are speeches from some IIT professors, some researchers from IIT, again from some industry persons. So you will get to know what exactly is going on in industry, how they are like what kind of work is going on in IITs in different areas. Okay, so how they are using these tools for their area. So mostly our examples will be from image, speech, or text. As I work in electrical engineering, I have some idea about application of these tools to some electrical engineering problems. But as I don't know or much about like metallurgy or planning, if those students can come up to me with some data, then definitely we can have solution for those problems, and then those students can present that problem. Okay. So this is how the course will be conducted. Is there any question or doubt about conduction of the course? So next week I will cover all these things. Then for next 15 days or maybe for 1 month, this data learning and perception will go hand in hand. And in the last week of the course, we have session on planning. Okay. So lecture times are usually 6 to 7:30, but as I have to cover this in 1 week or maybe in 4 days, we have a very short time, so I will be conducting lectures, maybe few lectures from 6 to 8. Okay. So in the first week you have lectures from Tuesday 6 to 8. Then I will try to bring the people on from industry and IIT on Saturday, maybe during your lab session. They may have some 1 hour or 1.5 hour session. Or else, if we have time, maybe we can keep 2 full days, maybe Saturday and Sunday in any of the week. You don't have any midsem or not many assignments. I will bring all the people, so there may be 10 to 12 guest lectures. Okay, where so those lectures will be focused on the actual work that is going on in IIT or in industry. So that is what is our plan to go ahead with this course. Now, if you have any suggestions, those are welcome. Apart from that, if you have any queries, I will address those. Okay. Now, so before sharing the next few things, now the forum is open for the discussion.
हेलो सर.
हाँ यस.
सर एग्जाम विल बी बेस्ड ऑन थ्योरी और प्रैक्टिकल?
इट विल बी बेस्ड ऑन थ्योरी. दैट नैसकॉम एग्जाम एज वेल एज आवर एग्जाम विल ऑल्सो बी बेस्ड ऑन थ्योरी. नाउ व्हाई
ओके.
वी आर एडिंग दिस मोर एग्जाम्स फ्रॉम आवर साइड इन ऑर्डर टू हैव सम सीरियसनेस फ्रॉम यू. ओके. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू प्रैक्टिस, नो मैटर वेदर यू go through Andrew Ng's lecture or maybe through any other lecture on this topic, you will not understand the concept or you will not come across the difficulties unless and until you practice. So practice thing is important, and more you practice, more knowledge you will have. Okay, so that's why we have brought in this mini project component.
ओके सर, थैंक यू.
Yeah. And so if someone has any difficulty in doing this course right now, they can also, they may leave. they may do it whenever next time such kind of courses are organized. Okay, so such courses will be organized throughout the year. May not be by the same department, but maybe from some other department. May not be for 2 months, maybe for 3 days or 7 days. Okay. Or else online also lot of such courses are available. But what we want, like as we are also investing our time, we want that same kind of seriousness and contribution should be there from your side also. Okay. So yeah, mini project problems can we? Yeah, so in mini project, you have to take some problem from your domain and solve it. Okay, so code may be available, data set has to be available, but depending upon the application, you should be able to understand the code and modify it. Okay, so that is what is our expectation. Now, if someone want to do it in economics, someone want to tell us prices like where, what will be a particular share price tomorrow? Okay, price of the share. So such kind of projects are also welcome. Okay, so you can choose it from any field. Now, so mostly in finance or image or video or speech or audio, huge work is already done and it is going on. So codes are freely available. But the problems in other disciplines like mechanical, electrical, planning, metallurgy, they are not addressed to that much extent. So you have good scope to work in those domain. Okay. Now, what kind of knowledge you need? So you must know linear algebra. You must know one programming language. Why linear algebra? Because most of our operations are on the vectors. So we know vector calculus, or we know how to perform column operation over a matrix. Then we can easily code that with whatever coding language we know. Okay. Now, if we know how to ride a bicycle or maybe a Maruti car, then it's not difficult for us to even drive a Mercedes. Okay, person who knows driving any simple four-wheeler can drive any four-wheeler. Just on the same concept, if you know one particular programming language, you can easily understand and learn other programming languages. Then you need probability and statistics. Why probability and statistics? Whatever algorithms that we will implement or whatever problems that we will define, for that we have to make some underlying assumptions. These assumptions are called as hypothesis. For this hypothesis, either they can be true or they may not be true. So how to accept them or fail to accept them is entirely based on statistics. And whatever operations we will perform, those operations we will do on some numbers which will be defined in terms of probability. Hence, the knowledge of probability and statistics is also equally important. Then, whatever algorithms we will write, those algorithms requires some kind of optimization. So we want that all our programs should be space efficient, time efficient, etc. Hence, if it is hence it is good if we have optimization knowledge, but if not, that we will cover in this course. So we will not teach it from optimization perspective, but wherever required, we will give you the insight of optimization. Okay. Now the books definitely will provide you the resources. So there is a book from Bishop, which is very famous. Then there is a book from Hasty. Okay. And as we will move ahead, all the things like whether the books or PPTs or PDFs, everything will be available on the Moodle page. So Moodle will be our main platform to access this course. Okay. So we are going to share the resources once we start our sessions. Okay. Then so same question was asked. Yeah, books we will tell you. So let me show if I have some book ready. Just a minute. So you can see that this book of Hasty, The Elements of Statistical Learning. Okay, this is one of the book that we are going to follow. And the other book is this Pattern Recognition and Machine Learning by Christopher Bishop. So this will be our main books for this course. So this is for whatever portion that I am going to take. Okay. Apart from that, for linear algebra, there is a basic book by Gilbert Strang, which you can refer to. There is a very good book by Hoffman and Kunz. Okay. So for linear algebra, you can so those who are not familiar with linear algebra, they can start with Gilbert Strang. So I don't know the name of the book, but these are the name authors. Okay. And a second book is, so this, those who are already familiar, they can go through this book. Okay, for probability, you have Sheldon Ross. You might have gone through some of these books, okay? Those who have already done the courses. Then, for statistics, I will tell you the book in the next. So there is a book by Sheldon Ross also, but that is on statistics, or this book on probability also covers statistics, but it is not that good, the statistics portion. So testing hypothetical statistic, this is the book by the author, just a minute. testing, this is a book of Salem Ross, if you can see. Okay, so this is the name of the book, that is Probability and Statistics for Engineers and Scientists. Okay, apart from that, you can have also a book of Populis. I may be wrong in writing the spelling. So Populus is Indian author. You can go through his book also. On statistics, there is a good book named as Testing Hypotheticals. Sorry, Statistical Hypothesis. Just a minute. This is the book by Lehman and Romano. Okay, that's where I made Hoffman. Okay, so these are the books for mathematics that we need. Okay, so this testing hypothesis. This has some cover like this. Okay. Then this is a book of linear algebra by Hofmann. So you can go through these books. I will also provide you the soft copy of whatever things are available. Then apart from that, these two books, that is Pattern Recognition and Machine Learning by Bishop, and The Elements of Statistical Learning by Hastie. Okay, then other professors will tell the book which you have to read for deep learning and other things. But there is a book of Ian Goodfellow on deep learning. Okay, so that book is also pretty good, or rather very good. This is on deep learning. There is another book that is D2L, that is, I think, dive deep into deep learning, or dive into deep learning, something like this is there. If you type d2l.org in Google, you will get access to that book. So dive into deep learning. Okay, so book is also available, and so this is the book. The codes are also available. It's from Aston Zhang. Okay, so these are the books that we usually one who is in this domain follows. Okay, so first of all, we need to build our mathematics concrete, and then we have to go for these books. Okay, so let me write down those names also.
is this fellow? Is Hastie's book. The Elements of Statistical Learning. So the language given in this book is difficult as compared to the language given in this book. So this book is written from research perspective, whereas this is from introductory perspective. Okay. Now apart from that, there are many series which gives, like you might have heard C for Dummies or the Complete References, like that for machine learning. Also, there are many such series available. So you can, like machine learning cookbook and all. So you can refer to those also, but those are not that standard. Okay. Then there are a few good authors like Simon Hyken, who has Neural Network book. Then we have a book of just I forgot the name, Jordan or something. So that is also a very good book. But but these are just like some Bible or Gita, sorry, this pattern recognition and Elements of Statistical Learning. Okay. So they have a very good content, hence people mostly prefer that, those things. Okay. So any other question? Coming back towards you. So, we have lectures till 6:30. May I know you are from which branch? You can type which specialization, Sanket? Computer SY. Okay. So you, if you are interested, you may join little late, and whatever portion that you may miss, you can do it through recordings of the series. Okay, but it is not possible for us to delay it little more. Okay, so we thought that as most of the departments have the lectures till 5 or 5:30. But if it is the problem, if it is problem with everyone, then definitely we need to think. Okay. But for a particular department, it is difficult for us. Any other question? Do you have any other query? So, can someone speak? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Okay. So, do you have further queries?
No, sir.
Okay. MTech is your last lecture till 6:20 Monday. Okay, so this Monday you may join little late.
No, sir. Actually,
yeah.
So Vijay here.
Actually, it's from Monday to Friday every day. We have lectures till 6:20. They end at 6:20.
Okay. So it is problem with how many of you, may I know? So I have already shared that sheet with you, right? So if you can, so after gender, in the next column, if you can mention till what time you have last lecture, then I will come to know that for how many of you it's a problem. Okay, and then we can think. No, so why can't you modify the sheet? You should modify. This is an URL with access to all. If I am shared. Am I in sharing mode? Yeah, so the thing is, see, this is, it's a URL. Okay, so yeah, so some people are saying that they can. Okay, and here anyone can. So see, people have written male, female. Okay, so in this last column, you can add. So those who are really interested in doing this course, okay, we will bring some solution for them. But it should not be like that you do it for 1 or 2 weeks and then you will leave. So if okay, so let me know that how many of you are really interested. And then for such people, definitely we'll bring some solution. Okay. And those who will not enter the details of, like I instructed some of you in the mail also, so I am going to remove their names. Okay, now someone, so I will not go into the detail of this, but those people, they already know that what kind of mistakes they did. Okay, so if they won't rectify those, if I don't have their email ID or WhatsApp number, or if I don't have their name, definitely I am going to remove them from this course. Now one more thing, we are allowing everyone, okay, who has requested, because we know that a lot of people are interested, and even though there are many courses available online, but you may not be able to figure out which one is proper, okay, and what are the contents that you actually need. So what we are going to do, so that's why this course is here to help you. Okay, now what we are going to do is just like if you are familiar with the lecture of Andrew Ng, if you have seen his courses or on Coursera or Stanford, there they lack some mathematical things. Okay, they do, those lectures do not have any mathematical background, but here we will bring in some mathematical component also. Okay, so it depends on how much time we can get to justify a particular topic, but we'll try to incorporate mathematics, because without mathematics, without understanding the mathematics, you cannot do research in this field. If you have to do some clerical like things, okay, or if you have to just write down some code of lines, then it's all right if you won't understand math. But if you want some good job in research in this field, then definitely you have to learn mathematics. Okay, then second thing, there will be hands-on also. So sometimes in lecture also, so it's must that you should have desktop or laptop, or sometimes on we will have lab on Tuesday. Okay, so there also hands-on is there. So through this hands-on and through mini project, you will learn the things, that is how to code, what are the problems that you will be facing, how to overcome those. Okay, so first, our first session will be on Python coding next weekend. Okay, so I'll stop sharing screen. Any other, so based on that, we will see how to adjust our lecture timings. Okay, so but sir has joined back. So if you do not have any query, I will hand over the session to him. Do you have any further query? You are unable to say gender column, but just I show. So if you are on mobile, there may be problem. Okay, you can ask any of your friend. So tell everyone that those who will not fill the entries here till today evening, or maybe tomorrow, or maybe yeah, to till tomorrow evening on Monday, as I need to submit this file, I will remove all of them through this list. Okay, so they cannot attend the lectures then. And I hope some of the students are instructed. I hope that they are all here. Okay, so they have to compulsorily attend this course. Sir, yeah, any further question? So I have given the link on the Moodle itself, that from where you have to download the Anaconda. So on that page you will get or else let me show once. So under announcement, so this might be visible to you, you can download Anaconda from this particular link. Okay, if you go here, there is a download option. Now you have to go for three point something. Okay, so these are the Anaconda installers for Windows, depending upon your operating system, whether 64 or 32, Mac OS and Linux. Okay, so for Windows there will not be any issue. Now as I told that you can in Linux you can install these things even from your terminal. Okay, so you need to tell me, I'm creating one poll, you need to tell me which operating system you have, and based on that then we will, like for Windows it is pretty simple how to install, but I will tell you how to install it on Linux and Mac OS only to those students who have these operating systems. Okay, so just I'm creating a poll and then I will hand over to the Bhatt sir.
Shall I start, sir, till the like poll is
yeah,
going
yeah,
to
yeah.
continue?
Yeah, you can start.
Okay.
So I will stop my video. And now,
Okay, ask the current presenter to close the poll before you start sharing. उसके बिना होगा नहीं सर। So thank you Suhas sir. Okay. So here we start, actually we are one like the basic opportunities that has been available with us to make our Google Pro or like our Python program to be worked with. So we have already discussed two of the platforms. This first one is that is not called Google Colab. So this we have already done that. So and second is the that we have discussed, that is GIT Hub platform. So we have download GIT Hub desktop at our system, so we can easily work with that, with the GIT Hub desktop. So there are the two main things that we have already understood. Now the second thing comes, actually these are the platforms where we can run our codes or whatsoever it is. So next time, like next thing that we have to discuss over here at the basic thing for all the students, so where we actually get the data, because finally what we are going to do, we are going to make some machine learning task to be executed. So for that we need some data on which one machine could be trained or one machine could learn through which, right? So we need to have some data repository that could be available to us. So the basic things that related to data for ML or the machine learning, we can get it from what actually the problem with the data is, must be understood. So why we need all processing of the data, further processing of the data that is required, because most of the data available is either unstructured or semi-structured. Unstructured or semi-structured means we cannot apply the data to the machine learning algorithm at once or directly. Before that, we need to clean that data so that it becomes available to the, it becomes suitable to the machine learning process. Because either it has some of the data that is missing, or maybe various problems associated with the particular column. Like for example, later on we will discuss what are the various data types available. So suppose that we have a mixed of data set that is there, so it cannot be applied to the machine learning process itself. So for that we need to clean the data, and that comes under the category called data mining. So data process pre-processing is not nothing but it is like data mining technique, and this data mining technique, and it includes the following steps. First is the data collection, that we collect the data, and the data pre-processing, that like tokenization, stop word removal, stemming and text formation, that we will get to know about all these things in later slides as soon as we will continue our course. We will move forward in our course. And third is like feature selection. So it can be easily understood by selecting the number of features or the useful features, out of the total number of features available that we will fix in upcoming slides. So this is all about data pre-processing. Now, what are the various sources where we can actually get the data? So for these sources are nothing but free data available sources. Like for example, the first one is UCI machine learning repository. This is one of the basic source of data where we can get the data sets easily available to us, free open source data set that is being available to us. So it is like UCI machine learning repository that we have with us, in which we can download the data from using UCI machine learning repository. Out of it, you can see over here, there are three main columns. You can easily see over here. This first column or the last column, what we can say, this last column belongs to the number of hits belongs to each and every data or the most popular data that we have. Like for example, iris data, it is one of the most useful or one of the most downloaded data over here. Then we have the adult data, wine data, heart disease data, then breast cancer data, wine quality data, bank marketing data. So here we have the numbers. These numbers are going to represent how many times this particular data has been downloaded from this particular website. Then the second column is used to represent the newest data sets. What are the newest data sets that is being added recently to this UCI machine learning repository? Like for example, Codon uses intelligent video accelerometer and gyroscope. And then Facebook large page network data, MBPM data, and so many kind of data sets that has been available onto this particular UCI machine learning repository. Along with that, we have some latest news that comes from various data providers, those who have been like uploaded the data onto this particular website. They have some sort of like information that can be available over here. So we have various kind of data sets that we can download from this UCI machine learning repository, or we can go through view all data sets. So whatever the various kind of data sets available with UCI machine learning repository, you can easily got it over here, as well as you can get the kind of task available. Like for example, if it is for a particular task that is called classification for related task, we have the total data set available, that is 419. Everyone is like, my window is visible to everyone now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, fine. Sir. And my voice is audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If I goes too fast, then please make me like stop over there. So I will make myself slow, right? Okay. So we start with this UCI machine learning repository. So we have various kind of task related data is also available. Like for example, if you don't know what kind of data will be more useful to you, suppose that you know the task, what actually you have to do. So for example, I have to do a time series analysis, right? Time series analysis means I have to make out some change from time T1 to T2, T2 to T3, like for example, landslide analysis, or say for example, there are earthquake analysis. So for that, we need some time series data. And I want to train my model based on some time series data. So I can simply go on to here, that is time series data, and click over here, and I will get various kind of time series data which can be available, like for example, air quality, emission SS samples. So I can get all the data related to the time series. Like for example, if I have to go to like, for example, clustering related task. So I will go to clustering and it will gives me the available data that can be useful for clustering. However, you can get the details from here also. Like for example, the name, that is 3W data set, or the absenteeism network, and data type that can be multivariate and time series. Default task that can be executed, that is classification in the clustering, and the attribute type integer and real that we will look after in further slides. And instances 1984. What actually these instances is, that is how many number of rows available into the data. Like for example, the total set data set available in this particular data set is 1984. However, in this particular data set, there are number of instances or the number of rows are 740. The total number of data set available is 740. However, the number of attributes related to it, that is number of columns in the data. Actually, whatever the data that we have into UCI machine learning repository, it is being available in .csv format. because it is the best, easiest format that can be incorporated into the Python using the library that is called Pandas. So every data set is being available in terms of number of rows and columns, that is in Excel or the .csv format, and somewhere it is being represented as XLSS. So again, the kind of notation it is being available, but it can be converted to CSV to Excel or Excel to CSV, whatsoever it is. And the year, again, it is given, like in which year this particular data set has been given to the repository, right? Now, for example, if I goes to, right, this is my main window. Now, suppose that if I want to download some data set from here, then you have to do nothing. You just simply go and click that particular data set. Suppose that I want to download this Wine data set. So I will, when I click this particular Wine data set, I will go to this web page where we have got these many options. Like, for example, download, then we have data folder and data set preparation. And then we have various related information available to the data. Like, for example, data set characteristic, it is multivariate, right? That then number of instances, again, I have already told you, that is number of rows or the number of data sets available, and area, that is physical. Then, for example, say number of attributes, that is 13. Now we have the missing values. Now out of total data available, how many are the missing values out of it? So it says simply no, means that none of the data is missing in the data set. Then the associated task, that we can go with this data set for classification process, and the attribute characteristic are integer and real, that we will find out what actually these values are, the type of data types that we will find. Now we have the source. This is the paper that we, if suppose I'm going to use this Wine data set, then I have to make it reference this particular data set. I have to cite this paper if I have to use this particular data set in our research work. Suppose that I'm going to use this particular data set in our research work, then I have to cite this particular paper, because it is very much ethical to cite the work or cite the person's work whom you are using in your research paper. Now it is having somewhat data set information, like for example, these data are the results of a chemical analysis of wines grown in some region. The region in Italy, but derived from three different cultivators. The analysis determined the quantities of certain constituents found in each of the three types of wine. So it is basically some data information related to it. However, the number of attributes, like for example, there we have 13 attributes. So it is being mentioned over here that what are these 13 attributes are. So these are the 13 attributes, or on the basis of which we have categorized a particular wine, like for example, alcohol, malic, ash, or whatsoever it is. Then we have attribute information over here. Then we have the relevant papers, those papers that has been published. So you can go through these papers and you can find out how actually this data set has been used for analysis. Like, for example, if you want to go to this particular paper, comparison of classifiers and high dimension suffix, this is the paper that has been published in 1992 using this particular data set. Then these are the papers, you can go through it. And suppose I have to download this particular data, then I simply go to this data folder and click it over here. Then I have various indexes available, like index of ML, machine learning database, wine. Then we have parent directory, index, wine data, and wine all names. So generally, the data that I have to download is simply having the extension that is called wine, that is the word that is dot data. So I simply click on it. Maybe the internet is missing. Hello. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, my slides are visible. Yeah.
Your slides are
no, sir.
Okay. Actually, there's some data or some internet connection problem will be there.
Yeah.
Is it okay now?
No, sir.
Is it visible now?
No, sir. No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay.
उनके में यूएसबी लगा होगा देना।
नाउ इज इट विजिबल नाउ?
यस सर,
ओके फाइन.
यस सर, विजिबल.
ओके राइट राइट राइट. सो एज वी हैव वी आर ऑन लाइक यूसीआई एंड वी हैव डाउनलोड सम डेटा सेट रिलेटेड टू अ पर्टिकुलर सी फॉर एग्जांपल लाइन और व्हाटएवर लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल हार्ट डिजीज और व्हाटएवर. इफ आई एम गोइंग टू डाउनलोड दिस हार्ट डिजीज डेटा I have to simply go to this thing that is data folder and I will download this data that is so we have various kind of data set available over here so we will simply go to like claim model node or new data or the process data or whatsoever Switzerland data we simply go to the new data so we have simply this data that has been downloaded or I have already downloaded this wine data also so we can work either with wine data or we can work with this so I will simply open it open this or we can click go with excel simply go with excel data sheet and file and we will open this We can simply view this, or we can simply, without writing this file, we can simply write star dot star. So simply find out all the data. We will simply find it. So we can simply, you can find out over here. It is like CSV file, right? Because it is being separated by a comma, or the we can say it is a comma separated value, right? So what we have to do with it, we have to convert this into columns. We simply put next. And then we have to convert this column or the commas into the columns. So we simply make this. It is a which needs to be replaced. That is comma. You can simply see over here. Everything has been converted into columns, and then we simply put next, and then finish. Right. So if here my data has been converted to comma to columns. So here you can find it out over here. Actually, we have 13 attributes. But suppose that we are going to count the number of columns. So we have total number of columns that is 14. So why this number of columns is 14? However, total attributes are 13. We have total 13 number of attributes, whereas you can find it over here. Total number of columns are 14 because this final column or the first column, which is going to represent 1 or what 2 or 3 and 4 and 5 and so on. Actually, this is for this is nothing but my binary output or that is my classified output actually, right? However, these are my number of columns that is equal to 13. Ultimately, because actually we don't have the header over here, right? Right, so we can add the header. We can add the header from the data set that has been that we have seen in the like on the UCI machine learning repository. So we can add the header over here. However, this is my classified output. So this classified output, if we delete this particular thing, and the total number of columns are equal to 30. Right. So we will discuss more out of this data set how we extract the data from this particular like we can going to manipulate this particular data using machine learning algorithm. That will be discussed in the next upcoming lectures. However, here we have nothing but to find out how actually we will find out the data. So this is one way to get the data from UCI machine learning repository. Another way to get the data from a free source that is called what Kaggle. You can download the data from Kaggle. So you can have the data sets. You can directly go to data sets. So here you can download n number types of data sets depend upon the data sets or depends upon the task or whatever it is. So you can find out various kind of data sets available, like COVID-19 world vaccine progress, Netflix movies and TV shows and so on. So there are various kind of data sets easily available on Kaggle. Even you can go through recently added data sets as well as the previously available or whatever the data set that you would like to have, you can easily find it over here in Kaggle. It is one of the best platform to get the data, and even every year they have a Kaggle competition for a best machine learning algorithm. So you can create even your own your own account over here. You can use the data, like for example, recently I used the memes data of Trump and various, that is Hillary over here, that I used one of the class lecture over here. So you can download this particular data from here and you can use it as your like analysis, because it's simply this particular data is converting various kind of actually hits and likes from Facebook and Twitter and all these things. It is the kind of data that is in here. So it is also one of the source where you can get the data. And another source of data set is you can get the data from Google Cloud public data set. This is also one of the platform where we can get the data. So ultimately, we have to find out the most favorable sources. It is the cloud, Google Cloud public data set, where you can download various sample data set from here, ecosystem related cloud products and various kind of data sets, like for example related to weather, Dow Jones, then various kind of data sets.
चल सकता हूँ मैं? चलिए
जी.
ओके जी जी मैं बस मैं 5 मिनट चलता हूँ.
So various kind of data set that is being available over here. So you can go through these or you can explore the samples. This is the AccuWeather. And you can download this Dow Jones data. We can have it like 19.5 million companies, 28 languages. And there are various kind of data sources available, right? We can have the solutions for like, for example, related to AI or various business applications. Or we can also have the Google code samples over here for this Google cloud platform, right? So however, there it having the commercial data sets also, but it has the some free data also. However, maybe you can get these two things are sufficient to make your exercises and all the analysis to be done with the help of these two things, right? However, one more data source is for the data is related to the Google Amazon Web Services open data repository. From here also you can So it is the Amazon Web Services, where you can choose the free data available related to Amazon Web Services. So various data are available over here again to compute the various things. So you can get the data set from Amazon Web Services. So as to like, for example, database that you can find it over here. That is, so here you can get the database. So again, it is a kind of very good platform, but you have to create a free account over here, then only you can download particular data. However, like for example, these two things, like for example, UCI and Kaggle. For Kaggle, again, you have to create account, but UCI, you don't need to have a create an account. However, you can download the data from UCI very easily. Then if suppose you are going to interested with some health related issues that you have to analyze on some health repository, then it is Global Health Observatory available here. Like for example, if you want to get some latest COVID data, you can get it from here. This is like from running by WHO, World Health Organization. So you can put the various related data from here. That is, for example, this, whatever the kind of problem it is, we have a particular related data. Like for example, if I have to have a, for example, Global Influenza Virological Surveillance. So this is the data related to Global Influenza Virological Surveillance. You can get data from here. So actually the data has been available in the CSV files actually. So like for example, if I have to health emergence. Like for example, if I have So various things, like for example, sustainable development goals, tobacco control. So whatever the kind of word, like water and sanitization, so it is the data related to this particular water sanitization and all these things are there. Or we can go to one more thing with what we can do. We can go to data and all data collections. So this is one more way to make it really clear. For example, I won't say, for example, tuberculosis data, then we can have this tuberculosis data over here. So you can go this, like these are the basic repositories available, like full report and all these. You have nothing to do with all these things. You have to come directly to the CSV file. This you can get it over here. The CSV file download data provided by countries to WHO to estimate the TB burden generated by WHO for the global tuberculosis report on comma separated values. Again, you got the .csv file from here. You just simply click the particular CSV file and it get downloaded from here, right? So you can get the data. So from this in CSV file, the diagnosis, notification, treatment, and then we have to download the data dictionary. It is about 1 MB file is here, so you can download from here. So it is basically you get this TB data or tuberculosis data. We can have it over here. So where we can get the in terms of rows and columns again. So we can have this new variable that has been added and then updated definition. Actually, everything, every column has been given a name variable. So whatever the kind of every variable like age group option. And with then budget CPP treatment and budget, whatever the definitions are there, they have been also going to be given over there. So you can easily get through this data for health analysis. Like for example, if I want to have some data related to influenza flu net, so we can get this data of influenza flu net. So you can download from here, so you can work on it. So these are the some set of data sets. Now suppose that some of the people students are really interested to go for this earth observation. Like for example, if they are very interested in image processing related activities. So this is the earth data that is being available from here. It is being provided by NASA, that is US Space Agency. So it is being given by NASA. So you can download the data from here. However, it is like much more easier to go to Earth Explorer rather than go to this Earth Explorer. So you here you can simply click it and you can get this Earth Explorer data, right? But for that, you have to give the name of the place. Like for example, if you want to download the data of Delhi, then we must know where actually the Delhi is. So Delhi can be here. I will go to it. This is India. And out of this India, I can get this data of Pune. So this is my data of Pune, right? So I will simply make a polygon over here and we simply download the data. Whatsoever the polygon that is going to decide, it simply create that particular polygon over here. We simply make it. So we make a polygon. This is. So you can get over here and we just use this map. So we can download this particular image from here only. So it takes some time because it is very like big images, because it is like this particular image that the device is going to download. However, you can redefine the area, you can like reduce the area, or you can, if suppose that you have the map of that particular area, then you can import that particular map over here. Suppose that you want the image of only Pune city, because it is the IFOV, instant field of view of the satellite. Actually, this is the image where actually look after my satellite is. However, if want to have this particular image, this particular part only, then we have to have this particular map of this particular area that can be superimposed into it, that we will look after if suppose some of you are interested in this particular domain also. So it is again You can download from here. So we have the data sets. So we are these are satellites that we have. Like for example, suppose that I want data from say Sentinel data set. The Sentinel is one of the satellites that is providing us the data. We have to just make it click over here and then okay, then results. So we have the search, it is going to search in the Sentinel 2 data. So with this, with the data of the Sentinel satellites, we get these kind of images. So these are the images that we have for Sentinel satellite data. So you can get all these images over here. This is number of lists, total, like it is the various lists. Like for example, this particular data is of the acquisition date 17/1/2021, then this is 17/1/2021. So we can restrict the dates. Actually, like for example, if you want to have an image of, like for example, year 2010, so we can get the image of 2010 of this particular area. Or suppose that I want an image of like so 1993, so we can get the image of 1993 by just simply pre-setting some controls over here and data sets. We can search criteria. We can change the dates over here, so we can get the like image for that particular year. So it is again one of the like best source for data. Even or you can go to another website that's called USGS. It is the United States Geological Survey. So you can get the product from here also. You can have various real-time data or the remote sensing data, or suppose that we want to go for the landslides analysis, volcano analysis, water quality analysis, earthquake analysis. So there are various kinds of analysis that can be pertained to the related to the USGS website. You can download the data from here, but it is in terms of imagery actually. So you can download the image, then you can convert this image into the CSV file, and then you can go through it. So these are actually even we have one more data set available. It is called data.gov. It is a US data available again, but very helpful in some of the analysis. So you can go through this. You have various data sets available for this United States. So you can go through it. If suppose that you want to have some analysis related to the US, especially actually these are the data set only for which we have the data related to the United States only. So we have the geospatial science data, ocean data. So we have the various formats, even like for example CSV formats. These are the data that are available in the CSV format. So there are a lot more data that is being available, right? But it's like it's upon you, at what kind of analysis that you have to going to execute, and what kind of algorithm that you are running, because ultimately it is like the use of this particular data. So this is all about like free data set available. However, there are many more other options are also available, but these are the main options that we have. So you can go through all these and have some hands on onto it, I suppose. And better you should come up with a system or the laptop next time if you don't have like that, because actually what had happened, it's like a hands on process. So along with the like delivering of the lecture, if you go through them directly, you can explore them more. As more and more you will explore them, you will get more and more like familiarity to how to use it. Like for example, if suppose that in case of a UCI machine learning repository, if I will like go through it, and we can have an option available whether that is repository or web. Like for example, it is a repository only. Suppose that I want to have it over here, that for example, any data set related to my analysis. Like for example, if I have a wheat data. So it can be either like find it out from the repository, or it can be downloaded from web. So it can get this wheat data from USDA, ERS. So again, you can get the wheat data from data.gov, because if you want to find out how actually my wheat is growing through various image processing techniques, so the data can be downloaded from here, where it is going to relate the growth of the wheat as per the season or the depend upon the imagery. So because we need to find out actually by the time actually where there are various government policies that we have that are going to be dependent or that are going to be more technology dependent. So it is like used in various government related policies also. Like for example, if suppose that there is a person who is going to claim that that particular area is not being like is being flooded by flood is being flooded and the whole of the wheat crop has been damaged. But how the government is going to analyze whether it is like what the person is saying is correct or not. So for getting this particular idea, they have like the time series analysis. If they have the image of the region on like before 1 month and this month, so they can compare this two images so that they can conclude whether the person has sowed the wheat or not, whether the person is saying correct or not. So there are various actually applications that where we can use these kind of algorithms or we can make this algorithm to work, right? So thank you for like listening to me and hearing me. And Suhas sir?
Yes sir.
Yes sir. So like it's like ended with the session and actually I have sir. So yeah, I have to go to actually instrumentation lab. Actually there is some KPIT people are coming, so I have to attend a meeting with them. So thank you sir, Hana. So I'm leaving right now. Okay. Okay.
Thank you sir.
It's okay.
Thank you all the participants. So Monday we have inaugural function at 6 o'clock. So it may start little bit delayed, maybe by 5 or 10 minutes. And after that, so there we have a key speech by our deputy director sir. And then from Tuesday onwards, we will be having our regular sessions on theory. Okay. So for the next session, just a minute. It's pretty legal to use all these data sets. Okay. Only the thing is, we need to mention that we have used it. And there was one more chat which I missed. So if you have any query, let me know. Okay. So thank you. Please join sharp at 6 p.m. on Monday. Thank you very much.